Hello, I'm Wendy from 3D Worldwide. In this video, we're going to create this plain spoon, or this plain teaspoon. So, let's get started. First of all, let's go to the main toolbar, Customize, and we're going to scroll down now to Unit Setup. Here in the dialog, we'll select Metric, Centimeters, then press OK. Let's pop over now to our Geometry panel, and drop down and we'll select the plane. The plane is going to be our reference guide. So we'll come over here to our perspective viewport and draw out a small plane. Go up and open the Modify panel. Now let's pop down to Parameters. In Length, we'll type in 3 cm. Width, 14 cm. In the segments, Length segments, I'm going to bring them up to 5. And the Width segments, I'll bring them down to 3. I'll drop down to the bottom of the screen and click on Zoom Extents. Now let's pop over to the main toolbar and click on the Move tool. This will activate our Transform panel at the bottom of the screen. Now I'm going to drop down and here in the Y axis, I'm going to right click and bring it back to 0 and the X axis too. This will just center my object in the center of the grid. I'll pop back over again and press Zoom Extents. Move up to your top viewport, click on the word Wireframe and select Shaded, then go back in and select Edge Faces. Just one more thing, right click on the plane and then we're going to scroll up and we're going to select Freeze Selection. This way the object won't move when we're working on it. Before we move on, let's go into our perspective viewport and turn on Edge Faces. Press anywhere now in the top viewport to activate it, then press Alt W on the keyboard to maximize it. The thick dark lines that you see running through the middle are the grid lines. I'm just going to leave them on. Let's pop over now to the panel, select the plane, and we're going to draw out a plane right here on the first line. Pop back over to the Modify panel now, and we're going to type in a length of 0.5, a width of 0.3. Then in the segments, length segments and width segments, let's bring them back to 1. This first piece will be the neck of the spoon. Let's center it properly on the plane. So we will right click to get the Remove tool, then scroll down here to the bottom to the Transform panel and right click on the Y axis and bring it back to 0. Right click on the plane and we'll convert it to an editable poly. The planes are lying on top of each other and they're a bit difficult to see, so we'll go to all 4 viewports, press Alt W on the keyboard to do that. Now here in the front viewport, you can just drag the small plane up a wee bit. Move back into the top viewport again, press Alt W to maximize it. We're going to start to create the bowl part of our spoon. We'll come out to the panel and select our edge mode and select this edge here on the left side. We'll be cloning and scaling edges. We'll hold the Shift key down and we're going to drag this edge to the side. That will create a new edge. Before I start, let's pop down and have a look at the Transform panel at the bottom of the screen. We'll drag our edge along our x-axis, roughly a negative 0.5 each time. And then I'll scale down on my y-axis. You'll also be able to follow along by looking here at your y-axis on the Transform panel. Actually, we're going to start by scaling this first edge, just slightly. So I'll right-click and select my Scale tool, and then scale it up a little on my y-axis. This small piece is the neck of the spoon. Let's select our Move tool now, hold the Shift key down, and now we'll drag out our first edge. This will be roughly a negative 0.5 on the x-axis. I'll select my Scale tool now, and I'm going to scale it out. We'll do the same again, hold the Shift key down, and drag the edge to the side. We'll scale it out. More or less the same width. The idea is that the end result is like an egg shape. I'll go slowly so everyone can follow along. We'll select that Move tool again, hold the Shift key down and we'll drag out another edge. And now we'll scale this one out also. This one's going to be a lot wider. We'll get the move to it again. Hold the shift key down. Now we can gradually start to scale the shape in. We're only drawing out a rough shape, as we'll be applying the NURBS or a smoothing technique after, and that will give us the result that we're looking for. Okay, just one more to go. This will be the tip of the spoon. Drag it nearly to the edge, and then you can scale it in. We won't scale it right down. That should be all right there. We'll come back after and we'll fix the tip of the spoon. I'm just going to adjust this edge. Bring it in slightly. There we are. That's an egg shape. We'll fix the tip after. Let's carry on now with the neck of the spoon. We'll create a couple of more segments for the neck, and then the rest will be the handle. So we'll select this edge here, hold the shift key down, and we'll just drag it like halfway to the center of the grid. Okay, we'll just release it a minute, then we'll hold the shift key again, and we'll drag it out now to the center. This one we're going to scale out a little, so we'll select our scale tool. This will widen the handle slightly. As I said in the beginning of the video, we're only going to create a plain flat handle. So the next edge, we're going to drag it right down to the end, well, near the end. I'll select my scale tool now and I'll just scale it out a little. Then I'll go back and give my move tool, hold the shift key down, and I'll create the last edge. And I'll scale this one in, just a fraction. We need to create a bit more topology, then we'll be able to come back and finish off the tip of the spoon and the handle. We'll give it a slightly rounded handle. Now we have a rough idea what the image will look like, let's pop back over to the panel and scroll down to subdivision surface. And we'll turn on Use NURBS Subdivision. We have a smoother subdivided result. Also, there is a yellow cage mesh that we're going to use a bit later on. Let's come over now again to the panel and we'll just turn off our Use NURBS subdivision. Let's start to create some edges now. We'll go to our editable poly and select our edge mode. Select the first edge. Then we'll pop over to the panel. Just scroll up and we'll click on ring. There we are. We have all these edges selected. Now we can scroll down now and click on the small settings icon for connect. Let's have a wee look in the caddy. Segments, we can type in 3, then press OK. We'll start with the handle first. Let's come over and select our vertex mode. I'll just zoom in. I'm going to select the first vertex, hold the control key down, and the bottom vertex, and I'll just drag these two back. Then I'll select the center vertex, and just drag it forward slightly. When we add a smoothing modifier to it, it should round off nicely. Let's have a look. I'll turn off my editable poly, and I'm going to scroll down and turn on my Use NURBS subdivision. That looks good. Okay, we'll turn that off again now. I'll just scroll along now, and we can do the tip of the spoon. Here we are, we have a good view. Let's turn on our vertex mode now. I'm going to select the first vertex on this row, hold the control key down and select the last vertex. Now with the move tool, I'll just drag them back, like halfway between the two edges. I select my scale tool and now I'm going to scale them out. Now select the first three vertices and we'll also scale them out. We're trying to get a nice rounder curve here. We'll come back to those two vertices on the sides. We're going to create a few more edges that cross from one side to the other. So right click and select the cut tool. The cut tool will let you subdivide the edges to create new vertices along these edges. Click on the top vertex and then scroll down to the bottom one. Click on it, then right click to come out of the cut tool mode. Now we've just created a few more segments and vertices. Let's turn off the editable poly. Press Alt W now and we'll go to all four viewports. Now with the move tool in the front viewport, let's just drag the object up a little. We're going to create the bowl part of our spoon, and we need a little room underneath. Let's come back over to the panel. We'll scroll down to Subdivision Surface and turn on our Use Norm Subdivision. Now we can pop up and turn on our vertex mode. As I mentioned earlier in the video, we have a smoother result. And also we have a yellow cage, which we'll be using now. Now we're going to select these set to vertices, not the tip or the neck of the spoon. And now up here in the top viewport, we'll just drag them down slightly. I'll zoom in so we can see it a little easier. Notice here in the perspective viewport, the dint. Let's just release them and drag these ones down a little further now. We're trying to create a nice curve. Let's pop down to the perspective viewport a minute. Don't move these three vertices yet, we'll move them next. Let's select the ones now that are on the sides. These ones here at the top, and these ones here. Just make sure we have them, not the tip or the neck, and we'll drag them down here also in the front viewport. I'll maximize the viewport so we can see a little easier. Release them and then just move these ones here a little bit more. Now let's come into our perspective viewport. Let's select these three vertices here. Now carefully we'll drag them down slightly. Then release them and just select the one in the middle. And then we'll drag that one down a little more. Zoom into the front viewport just to make sure nothing's overlapping here. I'll just move them slightly. Let's reselect this row of vertices again. Not the tip or the neck, just the ones that are in the center. I'll hold the control key down now and just select these ones. Check in the perspective viewport or the top viewport just to make sure you have the ones selected. Now hold the control key down and click anywhere in the left viewport to activate it, then Z to zoom in. This is what we'll see. What we're going to do now is to scale out these edges. So I'll just select my scale tool and scale them to the side a little. And then I'll drag them down. There we are, we've got a nice wide bowl that's smoothened out nicely. I'll go over to the stack now and turn off the editable poly. Let's pop into the perspective viewport, then press Alt W at the keyboard to maximize it. Just orbit around so we can see underneath. We have some nice curves. That's looking very good. Let's start to create a bit of shape to the neck of the spoon and the handle. You can see now it's too flat. Let's go back to all four viewports. Then I'll maximize my front viewport. Let's come back over to the panel and turn on our vertex mode. Now we're going to select all of these vertices on the handle. Just the handle, not the bowl part of the spoon. And we'll drag them up. And then I'll pull them to the side a little. Now select these end ones and I'll drag them in. We don't want the spoon to be too long. Just check with the reference guide underneath. Let's reselect them again. All the ones on the handle, we'll just select them. Drag them up slightly. I want the handle to be on an angle. So I'm going to reselect them all again and select the rotate tool. Just rotate them down. Then I'll get the move tool and I'll drag them up now. This is the angle I was looking for. Let's turn off our editable poly. Now before we move on, I'm going to change the name. I'll just type in spoon. I'll also change the pivot point. So I'll come up here to the hierarchy panel. Scroll down to effect pivot only, click on it. Then I'll click on center to object. And I'll come back over and turn off effect pivot only. I'll come back to all four viewports. The neck part is looking good. I like the angle down here. Okay, I'm happy with it, so I think we can move on. Let's maximize our perspective viewport. Here I can have a better view of the angle. Okay, let's add our last modifiers. So, select our object, and we'll scroll down under the modifier list and select the shell modifier. This will give us a bit of depth. The inner amount is set by default to 0, we'll just leave it there. The outer amount, I'll right-click on the bottom dial and bring it down to 0. Then I'll boost it up to something like 0.127, should be alright, 0.127. Just orbit around. The tip's looking good. The neck does too. The length of the handle and the width is also fine. We'll create a final edge now. It'll go right around the center. To do that, I need to add an edit poly modifier. So I'll just select edit poly from the list. Set my edge mode. And I'm going to click on one of these edges that run right around the center. Then I come back over to the panel and click on ring. I'll just orbit around to make sure I have all the edges. Yes, I do. I'll come back over to the panel now and click on the small settings icon for connect. Now here in the caddy, I'll just leave the segment set to 1, then press OK. I'll close the edit poly modifier. And I'll select now my last modifier, which is the turbo smooth modifier. Here we are, we can see it smoothed out nicely. The handle and the width's looking good. I'll leave the iteration set to 1, but I'll turn on the isoline display. That'll give me a little less cluttered look. I'll go to the top of the screen and turn off my edge faces. Before I finish, I'll just rotate it. Okay, and here's the end result. I hope you found this video helpful. Thank you for watching. Enjoy.